And welcome to Being James Bond. It is I, your humble correspondent, head of section, also known as Joseph Darlington. Welcome to my humble little studio. This time we're going to do a little Being James Bond commentary. Talk about what's new in the world of James Bond. So, what's new?
Well, Daniel Craig, we could use some good news here. Daniel Craig, will you return as James Bond?
Yes.
Daniel Craig has officially announced he will return one more time to play James Bond 007, which will make this his fifth outing as 007. So, what does it mean? What do you think we can expect? Is this good news? Are you excited about it? Let's talk about what it might mean. First of all, did you ever think you'd see Daniel Craig outdo Pierce Brosnan in terms of not only length of tenure, but in the amount of films he did? Pierce Brosnan was the golden boy. He was the guy that the filmmakers couldn't wait to get in front of the camera as James Bond. Brosnan himself seemed to love playing James Bond and was more than happy to go on. But despite high box office returns, Brosnan was dismissed after his fourth film. Enter Daniel Craig, who had a prickly relationship with James Bond, or sort of a love-hate relationship with James Bond. After the end of Spectre, Craig himself said, "I'd rather slit my wrist than play James Bond." Now, of course, Daniel Craig has since amended his comments and said, "Look, after you finish one marathon and somebody offers you another one, as soon as you're done, you're gonna say, no way. The guy needed a break, and I can understand that." But he sure liked keeping us in suspense. It's been 2 years since the release of Spectre, and not much news has come out. Nobody has seemed to raise their hand and say, yes, we're going to work on another film. It's only now that we're finally getting some information. And of course, Craig finally said yes. But with a lot of questions still unanswered, it's probably no surprise that we're only hearing today that Craig is coming back. We still don't know what studio is going to distribute the film, so as far as Craig's paycheck is concerned, we don't know who's going to sign it. We don't know who's going to direct the new one, and as far as we know, there's no script yet. Which leads us to the question, what do you think we can expect from the next film? Are they going to do a solo, standalone sort of film, or are they going to pick up where the events of Spectre left off? Given what they'd invested in Spectre, the story, the characters, the actors and actresses who are getting paid very well and are very well known, who are now invested here, I would say it's probably safe to say they're going to pick up where Spectre left off, but what does that mean? One rumor that was thrown around back in June was the idea that Eon would love to have a shared universe. Needless to say, everyone is getting the cinematic universe bug. Ever since Marvel's wild success with its own cinematic universe, other studios have tried to capitalize on the idea. Do you think there's any truth to the rumor that Eon would love to have its own shared universe? Well, yes and no. Yes, I believe that Eon would love to do something resembling a cinematic universe. I mean, again, everybody's doing it for one thing, and Eon tends to look at the trends and want to do certain things themselves. But is it remotely feasible? James Bond is a solo character, and while there are certain supporting characters that we all know and love, I don't see people lining up in theaters to see the Moneypenny Diaries or the standalone Q Adventures. Not to mention it's taking longer and longer for this studio just to put out one James Bond film at a time, so I do not see how they're going to put out multiple. But having said that, Spectre itself does show a somewhat mild attempt to go for a cinematic universe. The film tries to imply that all of the prior films were leading up to this. All points converge on Spectre. Everything up until now was by design. But was that successful? Well, let's take a look at Craig's 10 years starting out with Casino Royale. Even if you're not a James Bond fan, this film is absolutely wonderful. Great Fleming inspiration, great cast, great romance, incredible action, and the film does imply that there is a larger organization lurking behind the scene. Now, of course, Casino Royale was so successful that the filmmakers decided to do a direct sequel. Quantum picks up right where Casino leaves off and explores the idea of a secret organization pulling the string. The organization in this case being Quantum. Now look, I'm not here to bag on Quantum, but the funny thing is, all they had to do was use the title the way it was intended in the short story. Without getting into great detail, Quantum of Solace is a short story that is told to Bond about a married couple who basically despise each other, and in the course of their relationship, they are searching for a Quantum of Solace, a level of peace that they can live with. Now, that frankly would have worked pretty well if you just used it as that thought. Say, Mathis is talking to James Bond about how Bond himself is searching for some peace of mind, following the death of Vesper, not knowing what to think or feel about it. Mathis could have easily used the term Quantum of Solace to describe James Bond's pain and search for the truth, search for some peace of mind. The bottom line is that you didn't have to call this organization Quantum, and if you didn't name them Quantum, well, then they could have been a different organization later. But anyway, the series gets back on track with Skyfall. Skyfall takes a break from the evil organization thing for a while to deal with a former agent who is out to get revenge against M. Or at least that's what we thought at the time. Anyway, Skyfall is a true return to form, bringing back a lot of the charm and witticisms of James Bond, with a stunning color palette courtesy of cinematographer Roger Deakin. And of course, the film performed spectacularly, and the filmmakers were so excited about this, they decided to do a direct sequel. Once again, Spectre picks up where Skyfall leaves off, delving deeper into Bond's past and continuing on with the themes of the relevance of MI6. I won't delve too deeply into what's wrong with Spectre. A lot has been said about Spectre, and if you want to hear my thoughts on it, I did an hour-long review, you can check it out right here. But to sum up, I kind of think that the filmmakers were so excited about the potential fan service in the return of Blofeld that they thought the rest of the film would take care of itself. It doesn't. The story is lacking, the situation seemed really far-fetched, the action is pretty dull, and the cast, as great as they are, don't really get too much to do. By now you might be saying, okay, head of section, what does that have to do with Bond 25? The next film could be spectacular, it doesn't matter what came before. We know that the Bond series has ups and downs. And that's all well and good, but Spectre sort of left us off in a pretty weird position. The film Spectre takes great care to set up a very personal story, giving us an Ernst Stavro Blofeld, which also happens to be James Bond's brother, for better or for worse. Where the film does succeed is in its subtle tributes to the original Spectre organization. We get the familiar boardroom scene, a Swiss mountaintop hideaway, and even something resembling a volcano lair. And it's not only the settings that are kind of reminiscent of past films, there are also story beats that look really familiar. Bond essentially destroys the entire Spectre organization, basically blowing up the Death Star with one bullet, but still leaving the head of that organization alive. A man who has essentially dedicated his entire life to torturing James Bond, becoming the biggest terrorist in the world in the process. Whether or not it was too convincing, the film goes to great lengths to show us that Bond has fallen for a winged dove type, happens to be the daughter of a criminal. And Bond is so taken with her that he throws his gun off the bridge, quits MI6 forever, and the two drive off to the sunset. So what does that all mean for the future of James Bond? Is Bond 25 going to be more of a standalone adventure like films we've seen in the past, or is it going to pick up where Spectre leaves off? If this film picks up where Spectre left off, then the next chapter pretty much writes itself. Blofeld escapes, murders Madeleine Swann, causing James Bond to resign, go rogue, again, in order to seek revenge on Blofeld. Still not convinced where this is going? Check out one of the earlier drafts of the Spectre script. One of the earlier drafts had James Bond and Madeleine Swann about to drive off into the sunset. When Madeleine asks what's in store for the two, James Bond replies, "We have all the time in the world." So there you go. Are we looking forward to a possible retelling of the On Her Majesty's Secret Service story with Bond going out for revenge after loved one's murder? I don't know. If someone had told me days following Casino Royale that the story would continue to follow the Fleming books up until Bond's introduction to Tracy, along with the return of Blofeld, nobody would have been more excited. But they chose something else, with Quantum and Skyfall going in a much different direction. Now Spectre wants to backtrack and get back to the Fleming stories, I guess? So I guess we're just gonna have to have faith. Once again, my name is Joseph Darlington, head of section, and this has been Being James Bond Commentary. If you enjoyed this, you want to see more, check out our hour-long discussion of Spectre. Scott and I spent a lot of time dissecting Spectre, what we think was right, was wrong. If you want something lighter, check out our music review. We talked about the music of James Bond, that's part one. Part two and other videos are coming down the pike, I promise, along with volume two of Being James Bond. It is coming out very soon. I've been working hard on it, along with other videos. I promise there are a lot of things coming down the pike. So once again, thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please comment, please like and subscribe, all that good stuff. This is Head of Section signing off for now. We will see you next time.